be anything wrong with my life, because I have another 3 years to go before they are renewed. And he looked at him and agreed with me. He said, you know what, you're right. I'll get in touch with the state, the office of the state, amen, and let them know. And as I went on the yard and began my day, he sent me a message telling me not to drive until he went to Montgomery to get a little more information. And to be honest with you, Bro Robert, at that moment, I began to panic because, number one, I thought it would interfere with the operation of my personal vehicle.
All right, amen.
Number two, Brooklyn, I work very hard to get my CDL license.
And that's right.
Number three, the idea of losing my license been set well with me. Simply because I feel like having a license for me is a privilege. Can I get a witness here? Are y'all gonna pray with me? But nevertheless, he told me, he says, I'm on my way to Montgomery to handle some other business, and I'll find out more about it while I'm there. Then he says, just don't drive the state vehicle until we get it straight. Listen, I didn't have a problem with not driving a state vehicle.
Right.
It was just my personal vehicle and other commercial vehicles that I was really concerned about at that moment. So then, Sister Michelle, I took it upon myself to call the Alabama Driver's License Division in Montgomery to see if I can go ahead and handle this matter myself. Are y'all gonna pray with me?
Yeah?
And see, some of y'all know how it is. Some stuff can weigh on your mind so heavy that if you don't go ahead and handle it right then and right there, you won't be able to function right throughout the day. Are y'all gonna pray with me? Anybody here ever been like that? Amen. You won't be able to function right until you go ahead and handle it. You won't be able to have a peace of mind until that situation has been handled and under control. Anybody here ever been like that? I remember one day I was at work and something had been troubling me all day long. The Spirit told me, Brother Owens, to get on earth and go handle the situation.
Yes.
But I stayed there. Mm-hmm. And must remind you that I had one of those jobs where it's not hard to take off.
That's right.
You can just take off when you get ready, just about. Amen.
Amen.
But I try not to abuse my time.
That's right.
But because I stayed there, I was troubled in my mind, Bro Clinton. In the area where we were working in, I forgot to put the truck in park. Y'all gonna pray with me.
Amen.
And about 20 to 30 minutes later, as I was working, I noticed the truck. About 20 to 30 minutes later now, beginning to slowly roll down the hill. Can I get a witness? Listen, Sister Anna, since you're laughing, amen. I jumped off the machine that we were working on. I jumped over the ditch. I dashed up the hill to the truck. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Yeah. To try and get inside before it got too fast. But by the time I got to the truck, it was too late. Can I get a witness? It hit the bottom ditch and it ended up having to be pulled out and with damage to the front end of the truck. And listen, I said it and said it. Had I taken off, like the Spirit told me, y'all ain't gonna say that to me. All I need is a couple people that can help me. Amen. Had I taken off like the Spirit told me to take off, in the beginning, that never, y'all ain't gonna say that, it never would have happened. Can I get a witness? Some of the problems that arise in our life, if we go ahead and deal with them in the beginning, we can, good God Almighty, amen, we can overcome some trouble that won't be trouble if we go ahead and handle. Can I get a witness? The situation. Listen, if problems arise in your life, you need to start dealing with it then. I'm trying to help somebody here. If problems arise in your family, can I get a witness here? And you know what's going on, you need to try and handle it then. Can I get a witness here? If problems
problem arise on your job, you need to start dealing with it then. If problem arise even in the church, you need to start, well, good God Almighty, amen, start dealing with it then, because if you let a problem grow, the harder it is to deal with it. Can I get a witness here? See, sometimes we can let stuff go by because we don't want to hurt nobody's feelings. Can I get a witness? We let stuff go by. We let stuff just go on, even in the church, amen, because we don't want to hurt nobody's feeling. But, well, baby, I stopped by to tell you, amen, sometimes your feeling got to be hurt, amen, in order to know what's real. Are y'all going to pray with me? Can I get just one witness in here? But then, can I go back with my testimony? I called them, and for some reason, I have to point this out. I have to point this out. A white gentleman answered the phone.
All right, amen.
And I told him my situation. He pulled up my info and some of my CDL had been suspended, and he politely gave me another number to call. So I called the next number. And for some reason, bro, I have a point. This out as well. Yes, because there's a point I need to make. A black gentleman answered the phone.
Yeah.
And I told him my situation. He pulled up my information and saw that my CDL had been suspended, but he had one of the worst
attitudes. Amen.
Can I get a witness? I said, Brother Arnold, sir, is there anything you can do to help me get this situation straight? He said, your CDL has been suspended. He said, we sent you a letter in December that you should have answered in January. What? I told him, sir, and mind you, I'm being polite. I said, sir, for some reason or another, I missed the letter. He told me, he says, your license is suspended and ain't nothing I can do for you. Can I get a witness? And then he said, here's another number. This number, you call this number here, and they'll set you up when you can go back through the phase of getting your license all over again. Can I get a witness? And what I mean by that, amen, I had to go to take the test. He was telling me I had to go take the test. I had to go take the driving test. I had to do all these things. Again, he said, call this number and set it up. Can I get a witness?
All right.
And when I got on the phone with him, can I take my time?
Yeah.
I began to realize and accept the fact that it was my fault for not getting the medical card.
Okay.
Can I get a witness here?
Yes, sir.
And sending it in, and I began to think about all I would have had to do to get my license back, from renting the truck to doing the road test to all that stuff over again, which would be very costly. But let me ask you a question. How many of you know that a lot of the things that happen in our life is no doubt our own fault?
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? I'm going somewhere with it, amen. But how many of you know as well that we serve a God who look beyond your fault and see your every need? Can I get a witness to him? How many of you believe that? And see, the black gentleman watching now, the black gentleman that I had just spoken to, the power of his attitude had me feeling like it was all over. Can I get a witness there? The power of the attitude had me feeling like there was no need to talk to nobody else. And I didn't even want to talk to nobody else. I got through talking to him. Can I get a witness there? But the power of the Holy Spirit, I'm trying to help somebody else, it moved on me so heavy. Good God Almighty. And it told me to call the other number. Can I get a witness? This is my testimony. It told me, call the number. And I called the number.
Yes,
I followed the instructions. And what do you know? It told me your call can't be accepted.
What?
Can I get a witness?
All right.
It said it can't be accepted at this time. You got to call back later. Can I get a witness? And Robert, right then and there, I just knew it was over. I ain't calling nobody but the Spirit.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness? All right. But the Spirit moved on heaven on me and told me to call on the Lord.
All right.
Can I get a witness? He called me to call back again. And this time the phone was ringing.
All right.
But I was ringing more times than I usually would allow it to ring. Someone finally picked up.
Right.
Are y'all going to pray with me?
All right,
Lord. And I think it's very important that I point this out.
Yes, all right.
She was a white lady.
All right.
Can I get a witness? And her name was jacket.
All right.
And she was just as polite. Y'all ain't gonna say that.
Yeah, yeah.
As she could be. And I began to tell her my situation. She asked for my license number. And the first thing she said, I believe I can help you.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? And I ain't doing my testimony yet, but if you don't believe, I got my medical card in my pocket right now. She told me, I believe I can help you. Can I get a witness? She told me, she said, all you got to do is go to the doctor.
Oh, yeah.
After all this time, she said, all you got to do is go to the doctor.
Uh-huh.
Do a DOT physical.
Yeah.
And fax the information. Good God Almighty. But in the meanwhile, with my permission, she said, and with your permission, I will restore your CDL just to being an operator for the state.
All right. Thank you, Lord.
Until you get your medical card. In other words, until you get your medical card, you can still drive state vehicles.
Yes. Jesus.
And with driving for the state is not a requirement of a medical card.
All right.
And listen. For a moment, and I'm going to go. For a moment, all I can think about was if I had not called because of that joker with a bad attitude.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness? Yes, but God showed me that sometimes you have to go through some bad attitudes.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
To get the blessings that he has in store for you.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And sometimes those bad attitudes would come from folks you thought. Trying to get out of here.
Amen.
Would come from folk you thought should have been the ones that help you. Let me tell you something, brothers and sisters, amen. When you trust God to help you, don't look for no anybody to come and help you. God got people he chose and put in your path that will help you. Can I get a witness? I stopped by the towers, tell somebody we serve a God who works in mysterious ways. But now I have to mention that the reason why I know God was for me. Number one, the flesh kicked in and called me to panic because of the news I heard about my license being suspended.
Yeah.
Number two, as a result of the flesh, I wanted to give up as well when I talked to a gentleman who had a bad attitude, who told me that it was my fault and there was nothing he could do. Good God, my butt God.
But God.
And I say that again, but God, the Holy Spirit moved me to make a call that I never would have made had I depended on my flesh, which encouraged me and reassured me that if God be for me, who can be against me? Can I get a witness? But there's the Apostle Paul here, and I'm finna go. Here has expounded on and has shown the lift that God went to bring salvation to man and save him from in a wrath that will equip him for the victory over sin and death. Well, and listen, this text suggests that God is for us because we were foreknown by him.
That's right.
It's in the text. Amen. We were foreknown by him and predestinated by him to be conformed into the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren.
Uh-huh.
And those whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And those whom he called, he also justified. And whom he justified, he also glorified.
Knowing
first of all, he foreknew, brother, he foreknew us in eternity past. Can I just teach this thing?
Yeah.
Which means, Doretha, he was determined from eternity past to bring us into a special relationship with himself.
Right.
It was his desire to have a relationship with us before conception even took place.
That's right.
And listen, since God is all-knowing, God foreknew us in eternity past, and he knew us after the fact.
That's
right. Can I get a witness? In other words, God knew some work would have to be done.
That's right.
Or rather, some work would have to transpire in our lives in order to develop the relationship which we need with him.
That's right.
God knew we were going to be addicted to some ways. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Some ways that we wouldn't want to let go of.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Y'all ain't gonna say that.
All right.
Can I get one or two witnesses here? God know we were gonna be doing some things that we know are not right.
Mm-hmm.
God, can I get a witness? But because they felt good to the flesh,
we
were gonna do them. And God knew that there were some things that we were gonna do that were not right.
That's right.
In the lie.
All right.
Can I get a witness? Because of Adam and Eve, we were born in sin and an iniquity. Get this now, because this I'm trying to teach this thing to you. And so he knew, Brother Tim, on the way to developing that relationship, we were going to have to go through some stuff.
That's right.
Can I get a witness there? Right. He knew we were going to have to suffer some stuff.
Yeah.
God knew we were going to have to suffer some heartaches.
Yeah.
He knew we were going to have to suffer some tragedy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He knew we would have to suffer some disappointment.
Yeah.
He knew we would have to suffer some frustrations.
Yeah.
He even knew we would have to suffer some bereavement.
Right.
Can I get a witness here? Yeah. But the benefit of it all is found in verse 28. Mm-hmm. Y'all know that verse, amen. In verse 28, is that
we know
that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to his purpose. And notice, things work together for them that love. Can I get a witness there? Y'all gonna help me preach this thing. For them that love, can I get a witness there? That love God. Meaning, we have a will of our own as well.
Yes.
You can either love him or you can hate him.
All right.
Can I get a witness there?
Amen.
The Bible says you can't serve two.
No.
Can I get a witness there? He didn't give you no in between. He said you can love one or hate the other. Can I get a witness there? He didn't say you can love both of them. Can I get a witness? It's not possible to love. He said you can love one or hate the other. Now, someone may ask, what good can come from suffering?
Uh-huh.
And the answer is found in the next verse, which is, it conforms us unto the image of Christ, which is what God predestined that for us to be.
Right.
And do you know, the more you suffer for Christ, the more you look like him.
All right. Amen.
Get that on
Amen.
Own. Amen. Can I get a witness there? And I'm not talking about your facial. Can I get a witness there? But I'm talking about the things you deal with and how you deal with them. The things you suffer help you look like them. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here want to look like him, amen? Come on, somebody. Is there anybody here want to look like him, amen? You know for yourself, amen, that God, Christ didn't have everything easy. Christ had to go through hell and high water. Can I get a witness there? And you got to understand, some of the enemies were his friends. Can I get a witness there? I'm trying to help somebody here. A lot of his enemies were some of his friends. Some of the ones that were close to him was the worst one on his side.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And that's the same way it's gonna be in some of our life.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Some of the worst person people in your life gonna be some of the ones that close to you.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness there? I'm trying to get out of here. Some of the worst ones gonna be some of the ones that you keep close to you.
Uh-huh.
But nevertheless. Nevertheless, as I get ready to go on, someone may ask that question, but it conforms us unto the image of Christ, which is what God predestined us to be.
Where?
But now, to be predestined literally means to mark off.
That's right.
It means to be chosen before.
Uh-huh.
God chose those who know he would participate in his plan.
Yeah.
And then he extended it up to all those who respond to him in faith.
Mm-hmm.
But now that everybody who God predestined, he also called.
That's all right.
And I'm on my way to my seat.
Well,
in other words, it's the ones who hear the gospel, but you respond to it.
Yeah, right.
Help me, Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
When you hear the gospel, you respond to it. You don't just hear what he says, you respond to what he says.
All right.
By living according to what he says. But here's the thing. All are called, but few respond.
All right. Amen.
Y'all gonna pray with me?
Amen.
Listen. Dude was sitting in the house on yesterday, and he had the earbuds in his ear.
Mm-hmm.
He had music coming from these earbuds. From his phone. I called him, but he didn't hear.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Can I get a witness?
All right.
I called him again, but he didn't hear me.
Uh-huh.
But the next time I yelled at him.
Uh-huh.
Mm, can I get a witness?
Yeah.
And that's when he heard me.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how some of us are with God.
Yeah.
We so busy and occupied. Can I get a witness there?
Uh-huh.
Doing other stuff that we can't hear, and quite naturally, if you can't hear him, you can't respond.
respond.
Yes.
Help me, Holy Ghost. Amen. If you can't hear him, you can't respond. And if you can't respond, how in the world you want to be blessed?
Yeah.
Can I get a witness to that? Because one thing that I learned about my God, God wants a comeback.
Yes.
Can I get a witness to that? When God says something to you, God wants you to say something back to him. God wants a conversation. God wants communication. Can I get a witness to that? Touch your neighbor's neighbor.
Neighbor.
Here's a spiritual Q-tip.
Here's a spiritual Q-tip.
Tell your neighbor. Hear the word.
Hear the word.
Respond to the word.
Respond to the word.
By being a doer of
the word. By being a doer of the word.
That's your spiritual Q-tip.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness there? Look at your neighbor again. The neighbor.
Neighbor.
Now clean your ears out.
Now clean your ears out.
But those who has gone and have gone, he is also justified.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, because I respond through faith and righteousness, I am declared righteous.
Yeah.
Whereas I'm able to stand before God.
Amen.
Listen, I'm able to stand before God simply because not of my righteousness,
yes, sir,
but because of Jesus.
Jesus.
Who took my sins away.
Uh-huh.
And I became righteous through him. But Isaiah says, all of us have become like one who is unclean.
Well,
and all of our righteousness is as filthy rag.
Well,
can I get a witness?
Yeah.
And if I had time, man, I could probably mess your slide up if I tell you what Isaiah was really saying and what that really means.
Yes,
but I deal with it on another time.
All
right. But notice those who are justified.
Yeah.
He said he also glorified.
Well,
and it's the apostle Paul speaks of being glorified in the past tense.
That's right.
But really, being glorified hadn't even happened yet.
Yes, sir.
What I'm doing is looking at things as though they have already happened.
Absolutely.
Because the reality is, if we live the best of our ability for Christ, glorification will no doubt be out.
That's right.
Can I get a witness to that? For I heard the apostle say in 1 Corinthians 2:9, but as it is written, I have not seen, nor hear,
yeah,
heard, neither have entered into the hearts of men,
yeah,
the great things God has in store for them that love him.
Yes, sir.
And I gotta ask this question on my way to my seat. How many here love the Lord?
Amen.
Don't fool me now. How many here really, really,
amen,
really, really love the Lord? Can I get a witness here? I want to test you on something, amen. If you really love the Lord, you got to love God more than your mom. So y'all can pray with me. If you really love the Lord, you got to love the Lord more than your dad. Can I get a witness? You got to love him more than your sister.
Amen.
You got to love him more than your brother.
Amen.
Can I get a witness to him?
Amen.
You know, I love my wife.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
But if she leaves me for loving God, can I get a witness?
Amen.
Ain't nothing I can do.
Amen.
Are y'all going to pray with me?
Amen.
Somebody here, you may love your husband.
Amen.
Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
But if he leaves you because you love God,
that's all right.
Can I get a witness here?
That's all right.
And he refused to come back,
that's right,
because you love God.
Yeah.
Then tell him, brother, I'll see you later.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness here?
Yeah.
Because in the reality of God supplied me with you.
That's right. That's right.
Can I get a witness? Yeah. And before you came, God was taking care of me then. And if you leave out of my life, God still gonna take care of me. How many here believe that on today? How many believe that God will take care of you? God will take care of his own. Can I get a witness there? So now, Brother Cam, the question is asked in the text, in that 31st verse. Are y'all gonna pray with me?
If y'all pray with me, amen, I'll preach this thing and go on to the house. So now the Apostle Paul, he posed a question. He said, what shall we say then? In other words, what shall we say as a result of the fact that God foreknew us? What shall we say, Brother Robert, as a result of the fact that God predestined us? What shall we say as a result of the fact that God called us? What shall we say as a result of the fact that God justified us? Can I get a witness? And what shall we say as a result of the fact that God glorified us? Can I get a witness in here? Because surely if God did all of that, can I get a witness just for me? That must mean that God is on my side. Can I get a witness in this place? If God did all of that for me, that must mean that God got my back. Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody here, good God Almighty, feel like me today, that God is on your side? Is there anybody here beside me that feel like God got your back? Can I get a witness in this place? And if God got my back, I just believe God is protecting me all the way around. Can I get a witness in here? I feel just like God told Satan about Job. He said, I got a head. Can I get a witness in here? Of protection around him. Can I get a witness? And I'm here to tell somebody, you may throw your sticks, you may throw your stones. Can I get a witness in here? But you got to be careful. They may attack my body, but they can't attack my soul. Can I get a witness in here? Good God Almighty. If God did all of that for me, surely God must care about me. Good God Almighty. Brother Clint, it must mean that when trouble arises in my life, I don't want to have to worry because God got my back. And the reality is, trouble don't last always. Can I get a witness in here? How many of you know you going to go through some trials and tribulation? But good God Almighty, I'm so glad trouble don't last always. Can I get one or two witnesses in here that know that trouble don't last always? Can I get a witness there? And the reason I know that trouble don't last always, because all I got to do is do like the disciples did when they were on the boat and wake Jesus up. Can I get a witness in here? Is there anybody here to know that if you cry out to the Lord and the Lord have mercy on me, God will, good God Almighty, he'll cause the wind to cease. Can I get a witness? He'll cause the waves to lay down and be calm. Is there anybody here know that we serve a God who's able to do anything but fail? Can I get one or two witnesses? When the enemy comes in like a flood, I don't have to worry. Can I get a witness? Because God is on my side. Can I get a witness? I heard him say, I will lift up a standard against it. Can I get a witness in here? Did anybody ever know? Good God Almighty, when God is on your side, can I get a witness in here? Good God Almighty, you may be like some of those palm trees down in Florida. Can I get a witness? They shook and they shook. Can I get a witness in here? They shook and they shook. They bent and they bent. Can I get a witness? But they don't break. Can I get a witness? Yeah. God is on your side.
be on your side. Can I get a witness? Because I heard him say that he'll be your friend, that sticking closer than any brother. Is there anybody here know you got a friend in Jesus? Yeah. Can I get a word or two witness? Anybody here know you got a friend in Jesus? I stopped out here to tell somebody, if God be for you, who can be against you? Somebody here can testify that the Lord was for me when I was laying on that bed of affliction. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here know that God was on your side? Another person may say, God will for me what my bill would do, because he made a way out of no way. Is there anybody here know God is on your side? Say yes. Tried the Lord, and he showed up, and he showed out. If he showed up in your life, you ought to touch somebody. And the neighbor, good God Almighty, when I was about to give up, God showed up. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here ever had some dark days in your life? But did God stop by your house? Say yeah. Don't look at me, but all of a sudden, you give a moment of praise. You look to God and thank him alone. But thank God has done for you. If he does something for you, you ought to give him praise. If God be for you, who can be against you? Can I get a witness? About my enemy, can I get a witness? Because the same God who made me is the same God that made my enemies. Can I get a witness? Won't he make your enemies your footstool? Say yeah. If God be for you, if God be for you, who can be against you? Can I get a witness here? How many here can truly say that God is on your side? Can I get a witness here? How many here can truly say that God is on your side? How many can truly say, Lord, I ain't always been what I should be? Can I get a witness here? I ain't always been the person I need to be. Can I get a witness here? And listen, I ain't always been the companion I always need to be. I ain't always been who I need to be. But I thank God. Can I get one witness? Is there anybody thank God that you're not who you used to be? If you know you've been changed, shake your neighbor's hand. And the neighbor, I've been changed. But God, grace and mercy. preaching about it.
Preaching about it.
Looking back over my life.
Thought I couldn't make it.
But God called things that happened to my life.
If God be for you,
yes,
who can be against you?
Amen.
Keep playing, amen. Keep playing. That section of Romans, it speaks of how God brought salvation into this world. God moved on the heart of his people. Listen, God had a plan even before we were conceived. God had a plan. Even before we thought about even being made, he told Jeremiah, he says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. He said, I sanctified thee. God said, I predestined you to be a prophet unto the nation. God had a plan that involved Jeremiah before he was even conceived, before he was formed in his mother's womb, which is an indication to me. When God tells me that, he tells me that my relationship with him ought to be better than any other relationship that I have on this earth. It's all right to have a relationship with mama. It's all right to have a relationship with dad. It's all right to have a relationship with family, brothers and sisters. But watch this. It's more important to have a relationship with God. Because the reality is, if you don't have a relationship with God, and mama may have a relationship with God, daddy may have a relationship with God, but if you don't have a relationship with God, how do you expect to see them? How do you expect to see them when you leave this earth? Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
It's all about having a relationship. It's all about getting to know who Christ is for yourself.
Yes.
For yourself. A man, I heard a preacher say something that's been troubling me. It ain't been troubling me, but it made a lot of sense. He says, there's not a lot of substance like there used to be in the church no more. We so quick to come to church and go home until we don't realize that another generation is coming on soon. But if that generation has been taught how to dedicate themselves to God, if they haven't been taught to dedicate themselves to God, that generation is going to be lost. Because we live in a day and time nowadays, amen, when the preacher says something, folk won't get mad. I ain't got to say that. Even if it's the truth, they get mad. Listen, I was telling a guy, that, and we finna go because I got to go MC another program. I was telling a guy on the other day, and Robert, I had to repent myself. He talked about how they used to go to church all the time. And what resonated in the parent's life transferred into the children.
That's right.
What do you mean, Reverend? Well, they spend a lot of time in the presence of God until it's
church. But when they go home, they imitate church.
Y'all gonna say nothing to me.
Amen.
The more things you adapt to, that's what they revert to the most. Can I get a witness? It get to a point now, amen, that they trying to cut you out from going to church on Sunday. They have graduation on Sunday. They have all these different things on Sunday. On God's day.
Putting a whole lot of stuff before God, and guess what? When they get older, they put God last. And then when you put God last, it ain't long before He be a distant from you. God has to be first in your life. And I learned a long time ago, when I hear something that's true and I don't like to hear it, say out, you're going about your business.
Ask God to help you to get better. Amen. Because evidently that's an area God trying to work on you in. Can I get a witness? But anyway,
the guy was talking to the other day, I told him, man, you know what? I'm guilty. Yeah. In my church to sit here, I didn't be the example like I should have been.
I'm sorry, let me go back. They just came, they're just June. I was stuck on 42.
God bless you, amen. If God be for you, who can be against you? Amen. The power of God is greater than the power of people. I don't care who got an attitude with you because of who you are. Let them have the attitude. Amen. You gotta treat them the way you want to be treated. Can I get a witness? Because if I was stuck on that man's attitude, I never would have made that call. And can I get a witness? But because I want to study that attitude, treat them right, God bless me. I got my medical card in my pocket, and I ain't stuck with nobody else say, amen. I got another 2 years. Touch your neighbor by the hand. Say, neighbor, is God before you? Reverend Anthony said this. According to the word of God.
If he be for you,
who can be against you? Lord, I thank you right now, God. Lord, bless your people, God. Keep your people, God. Lord. Strengthen them people, God. Lord, I pray right now, God, that you make teaching ministry strong within me, God. I pray, God, that you give me the teaching word, God, that I have to give your people, God, so that people would know your word, God, so that I won't just stand up here, God, and just make noise, God, because I have a love for you, God, and I desire to do your will, God. I pray, God, that you give it to me. Give it to me, God, like never before. We thank you. I bless your name, God. Lord, I bless those. God, I pray for those in Houston right now in recovery, God. I pray for those who are in Florida and other states right now who are recovering, God. Lord, we know that you are a way maker because in either or, God, in Florida and even in Texas, God, I've seen people still praising you, God. I've seen people still giving you glory, God. So, Lord, God, I know, God, if they praise you and they were going through it, I ought to be able to praise you and I miss that, oh, God. I ought to be able to give you praise, God, and it passed all by me, God. I ought to be able to tell you, thank you, God. Bless these people as they go to different destinations, God. Take care of them in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Let the church say amen. Come on, y'all can shout a little better than that. Say amen.